evening, Cedar Grove in Pittsburgh. Welcome to our Wednesday night devotion time. Good to have you. Let's open in prayer. Lord Jesus, thank you for this time tonight. Thank you for these two churches. Lord, we are here to worship you and to devote and spend time with you. Thank you for your mercy and grace and goodness to us. And thank you for meeting with us during this time tonight. We ask these things in your name. Amen. What I want to do tonight is make an introduction. We are going to start a Bible study this coming Sunday at 3 o'clock in the afternoon. And the title of this study is Supernatural: Experiencing the Power of God's Kingdom. And it's by Carolyn Moore. And she wrote an awesome introduction in the book that we're going to be looking at. And I want to read the information she had to sort of promote this and to whet your whistle a little bit. If you have thought about coming, and maybe this will help encourage you to come. She starts out using Philippians 3, 10 and 12. Paul wrote, "I want to know Christ, yes, to know the power of his resurrection, not that I have already obtained all this or have already arrived at my goal, but I press on to take hold of that for which Christ Jesus took hold of me." Philippians 3, 10 and 12. "I want more. I am hungry to see the power of the Holy Spirit in our midst." Hungry. I'm not talking about so much that passes these days for Spirit-filled experiences. We have defaulted to bragging. We tell too many big fish stories. We talk of huge moves of God that are not quantified by fruit. And we call our good feelings moves of the Spirit. My concern is that we sometimes misrepresent the Spirit by assigning to Him feats easily accomplished in the natural and by making more of what happens in our corporate gatherings than is actually there. We have overplayed our hand and become accustomed to calling any emotional response a great move of God. Meanwhile, we are completely shortchanging what must surely be a much more awesome and beautiful power than fleeting experiences that result in no lasting transformation. What is most disturbing is that we cling to stories of Holy Spirit power in other places at other times, as if by only having heard the stories, we can somehow claim participation. While I certainly celebrate with followers of Jesus in other countries who report awesome healings and even resurrections, I believe these to be true. I'm not content to let what is happening in other places suffice for my own experience and person and work of the Holy Spirit. I am hungry for the power of the Holy Spirit to fall on us here. Cedar Grove and Pittsburgh. We too are responsible not just for learning the lingo and culture of Spirit-filled living, but also for watching for the actual work of the Spirit in our churches, our families, and in our lives. Aren't you hungry for more? I'm starving for it. And I've decided to lean in and get more intentional about watching for what the Holy Spirit is actually doing right here, right now. I'm praying for the kind of personal and corporate renewal that can be attributed to only the power of God. I'm no longer content to be encouraged by a good word or titillated by emotionally charged moments. I want to be changed by the presence and power of the Holy Spirit. And I want that for those I pastor. I want that for you. In Luke 9 through 9 and 10, the followers of Jesus have power and authority to cast out demons, cure diseases, proclaim the kingdom, and heal the sick. That is a far cry from what we are experiencing in most churches today. Until we are honest about that, I'm not sure we'll be able to move past the weak substitutes for which we've settled. How many of us are willing to stop calling it the power of God when we leave church feeling good about ourselves? How many of us are willing to lean in and start crying out for the real thing? Don't American Christians also deserve to see the power of God and become conversant in the real and powerful work of the Holy Spirit? Aren't we, their leaders, responsibility for properly defining that power and calling our people to that hunger? The one thing of which I've become most convinced is that for us to have any hope of breaking through to something deeper, we must get honest. Until we stop calling every warm experience a genuine move of God, we won't find the deeper well. It is as if we found the stagnant pond in the desert and have camped there when an oasis of sweet, pure water is just ahead. I'm hungry for more and tired by less. If you are actually experiencing it, I want to hear your stories, your first person, real life, recent, authentic stories of the power of God at work in your own life and in your community. I want to hear first person healing stories that have resulted in works that glorify God. I want to hear real stories that have resulted in spiritual fruit and advance the kingdom of God on earth. I want to hear proof of the authentic, awesome power of God working in our churches, in our lives. Paul's words resonate deeply with me. I want to know Christ, yes, to know the power of his resurrection and participate in his sufferings, becoming like him in his death, and so somehow attaining to the resurrection from the dead. Not that I have already attained all this or have already arrived at my goal, but I press on to take hold of that for which Christ took hold of for me. I am pressing in, and I invite you to join me, and I want to know the power that resurrects people from the dead. I want more than just good church. Don't you? So that was her introduction to the study. I think it will be an excellent study. There's a question posted on the back of the DVD. Are you hungry for the power of the Holy Spirit? There is no substitute for the supernatural power of the Holy Spirit in our lives. And that, those two verses in Luke, whenever Jesus is commissioning the disciples, Jesus gave the 12 disciples power and authority. And then four things: to cast out demons, to cure diseases, to proclaim the kingdom of God, and to heal the sick. One commentator said, to cast out demons and to cure diseases was connected because sometimes whenever somebody has a demon, then that causes diseases. And so that's why those two are sitting there. But when Jesus commissioned the 12 disciples, he gave them power and authority. Cure diseases, proclaim the kingdom, heal the sick, cast out demons. In 2021, that same commission is given to us as believers. the power and authority, the presence and power of the Holy Spirit. And that is available to us as Christians. I hope that that has whetted your whistle just a little bit. We're going to start Sunday at 3 o'clock. Usually lasts around an hour. But I really, really believe that you will enjoy it if you come. The book that I have, we have books, and from what I've looked at so far, I think this is going to be one of the best ones that we have done. But keep that in mind and think about it. When you come, there will be books, and so I think you will have a really interesting time. Carolyn Moore, the writer, is going to, we'll open up with a 17-minute thing by her on a DVD, and then we will hop into the book. So keep that in mind, and I encourage you to think about coming. I believe it will be a blessing, and the church will be blessed, and the ones who come here. Let's pray. Lord, we thank you and praise you. Thank you, God, that we have this information that we're going to go through about how we can experience and know supernatural power, because you are a supernatural God. And we definitely need supernatural help in this day and age in 2021. We are no match on our own. We need you. We need your power and your presence on our lives. Bless us as we go about the rest of this week until we see each other on Sunday in church. We ask this, Father, in your name. Amen.